president. I am on the Townsburg board, and I am a big cheerleader for Green Lake. I am so pleased to be here, having spent the week working with your beautiful children, learning about Broadway, singing songs of Broadway, getting some dance moves in, you'll see in a minute. We've learned a lot about projection and diction and enunciation and breathing and control and how to move and sing and dance, put that face forward, and just the whole joy of being on stage. We went through and got some stage names: Bob, Bertha, Serena. It's so funny, all these kids. I said, now you're not who you are anymore. Now you're a person on stage. You've got to get that little personality going. I have to say some thank you before we begin our show, of course. The first one is I'd like to thank Izzy Loberg, who was our choreographer helper. Ari Arnavite has done the last 2 years, but unfortunately she had a conflict this year, so we had to have an understudy, right? So it became Izzy, and we're so glad that she was able to do that with us. She's very calm and organized, just like her mother, and it was wonderful, wonderful having her with us to teach the kids their steps and moves. I'd also like to say a big thank you to Hayden O'Neill. Hayden came in, she's Molly Ryan's granddaughter for the week, and she's our backstage manager. I don't know what I would do without this woman, so thank you. I'd also like to thank the Hildebrandt family, who are not able to attend today, for sponsoring the kid camps at Town Square. It really is important that we have sponsorship because, of course, as you know, this beautiful community center that we have, we are not supported by taxes. It's all by private support. And of course, all of you here, I know, have had your share of fun putting money in here and making this such a successful community center 10 years today. So I'm like so proud of that. Show begin. We're going to start with our first piece, our first song. It is from the Broadway show, 42nd Street. 42nd Street is a major thoroughfare in Manhattan, mid-Manhattan, around the Broadway district. And this show is, 42nd Street was written, created from a book written in 1932, and then made into a movie in 1933. In 1980, it came onto Broadway as a production. The synopsis in a nutshell is, this young lady from Allentown, PA, comes to Broadway thinking she's going to be on stage and so excited and cannot get a part. And she's frustrated, she kind of hangs around the theater for a while, gets to know some of the staff, the characters, the cast, and then she's like, I'm just going to go back to Allentown. But the star of the show breaks her ankle. Oh no, who's going to go on stage? This gal from PA, she's been watching and she's so excited. So now she gets to go on stage, and she becomes this major success in Hollywood. So she sang this beautiful song, Lullaby of Broadway. So we are going to begin our show with that beautiful song, The Lullaby on Broadway. Hit it, Hayden!
Travel.
I was piano students up here in Green Lake. I'm really retired. I have been doing music for all my life. Choirs and piano teaching for, well, piano teaching for over 40 years. How did that happen? I'm 39. But anyway, I love teaching. I love being with kids. I love sharing music. So it's always been my joy. So I, Ariana's not here, but I got her brother, and her brother plays the piano. So he's going to come with me, and we're going to play a special tune called Give My Regards to Broadway.
Thank you.
have their costumes until about the third morning. Because they're like, what's our costume this year? What's our costume? I'm like, you'll find out, learn our song first. And then we get into the costume, and they have so much. I love doing this. It's just, it's such a ride to think about what should I have them wear, what would be cute on it. And they're really good. They're just, it's great doing this. Thank you for sharing them with me. It just, we go downstairs for lunch around 11, 11:15 every day. We sit in a circle, we talk, and we get a lot of entertainment. I get a lot of entertainment from these children. And they learn to bond, right? They are becoming friends. So when they see each other, we have a nice group of locals, a nice group of second homeowners, we have a nice group of people visiting their grandparents for a period of time. So they get to see each other, and this is the third year I've done it, so they've gotten to bond, get to know one another even more so. So that's a byproduct that I really encourage for our camp this week. So anyway, moving on now to our third Broadway production piece is coming from Hamilton. Hamilton was written by Lynn Miranda Manuel in 2000, and it took him 7 years to write this musical. He is one clever dude. The lyrics of the play, who has seen Hamilton either on stage or on TV? Yeah, well, I hope you all get an opportunity to see, because just for the lyrics and his style of writing, it's just worth seeing that. The play is built, it's based on Alexander Hamilton, of course, founding father of ours. And we see George Washington and Aaron Burr and Thomas Jefferson and Lafayette, such a variety of wonderful founding fathers. So of course it's during the Revolutionary period, and King George III is not happy about his subjects. They are not behaving, they are becoming obnoxious and avoiding him and not even want to be part of the English regime anymore. So King George comes out on stage during the Broadway show at Hamilton to sing this little soliloquy about his love for his subjects. So without further ado, madam, if you wouldn't mind queuing up our beautiful, you'll be back. I'll be back too, just give you 1 minute. I guess they're ready. That's our lovely. Oh, never mind. Okay, go ahead, Hayden. Thank you. Oh, sorry. Excuse me. One more. I'd rather have to do something first, and that is, are you ready to march in, my people?
Yes.
Okay, come along.
You say the price of my love's not a price.
see they like to dance and move and shake, and I said to the people downstairs, I said, no, we do not have elephants or hippopotamuses up here, sorry. And then poor TLA, my friends that are here, all week long, they could probably be up here singing and dancing with us, right? You know? Anyway, it's been a pleasure. Again, as I say, thank you for coming and being part of the show, sending the children. It will happen again next year, God willing. It sells out quickly, so keep your eye on your newsletters. You're getting them, right? The newspaper articles, yes. Social media, we're on Facebook and Instagram. There's nothing you should be missing. We have so many cool things going on in Town Square. The kid programs. We have the art stuff. We have a new hub. The hub is downstairs. It's for little ones and imaginary play. It's adorable. We have kids that are little, a grade one little, coming and let them play. Supervised. The makerspace is new. The makerspace is a creative outlet for kids. It can be during the day. It could be a rainy day. It could be a sunny day. They have pop-up makerspace time. 10 o'clock on Mondays with a supervisor where they do crafts. Otherwise, there's a whole bunch of stuff to do in the vault. The fitness center is upstairs now on the first floor. We have yoga on Tuesday and Thursday. We have bingo on once a month on Saturday. $5,000 coming up this month. And then we have the market at Town Square on Friday afternoons. The tap coming forward, we have Harvest Fest. We have Harvest Fest, Supper Club with Frank Sinatra. That was a fun one last year. Come back, people. That was a lot of fun. We're going to have an October pumpkin carving party for the children. And I especially want to encourage you to come with 10-year-olds and older to hear Frankie Jo Moscato. She is an amazing young woman who made it to American Idol's first round. She's from Oshkosh, and she's coming Labor Day weekend to perform the concert on the pond. And she also will be will host a master class for her for 10 years and older children, so they can learn a little bit about her journey as a musician, a young musician. So as you can see, that just scratches the surface of what we do here. We have a lot of great things. So thank you for your support on that. I really appreciate it. When you leave today, you're going to find Georgie Cullen and Pierce Lane. They're going to bring these cute little white top hats. They're going to stand by the door, and they pray that you would consider digging, there it is, that $20, $50, or $100, put it in the hat. Help us keep this programming going for kids. It's what it's all about, right? It's really wonderful. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Now, last song. This is, you talk about energy, wait for this one. This is from the Seussical, the musical. Dr. Seuss. Who doesn't like Dr. Seuss? I swear I learned to read by Dr. Seuss. Cat in the Hat, 1957 that was written, Dr. Seuss. 1960, Green Eggs and Ham. It came onto Broadway. It's a joyful, silly musical combining a lot of his wonderful books that we all adore. And today we're going to end our Broadway show here in Town Square, here in beautiful Green Lake, here in stunning Wisconsin, here in the world with Green Eggs and Ham. Thank you for coming.